tonight's budget will invest in infrastructure and skills to create more jobs and provide incentives to business to do what they do best, hire, to innovate and to grow. And tonight's budget will see record commitments on essential services, disability support, mental health, aged care and women's safety. Australia's strong position today is not the result of luck. Australia makes its own luck. And tonight's budget will lay out the Morrison government's economic plan to secure Australia's recovery. Are there any questions?
Treasurer, your second pandemic budget, how hard was this one to put together compared to the one in October?
Well, every budget is challenging, and in a pandemic, it's even more so. A lot of work has been put in by a lot of people, but tonight's budget is not about us. Tonight's budget is about the Australian people, about guaranteeing their essential services, about creating more jobs and keeping Australians safe from COVID-19.
Treasurer, it's expected the NDIS might wind up costing more than Medicare, quite soon as well. How significantly are you going to have to change the NDIS to make it sustainable?
Well, in tonight's budget, you'll see additional funding for the NDIS. This is a wonderful program. It's made a profound change to the lives of Australians with disabilities and their families. We all know stories of people who have been assisted by the NDIS. And under the coalition, the NDIS will always be fully funded. We need to ensure it continues to remain sustainable. But under the coalition, we are deeply committed to the NDIS and we'll always ensure that it's fully funded.
Last question. Okay, Treasurer, at what point do you think next year the borders will open and how much of a wildcard factor is the vaccine rollout speed?
Well, in tonight's budget, we make some assumptions around the vaccine rollout, around border closures, the containment measures that are put in place in respect to COVID-19. But it's very hard to be precise in the middle of a pandemic. There's a lot of uncertainty globally, domestically, with respect to the virus. So tonight's budget has those assumptions in place, but the key point is we'll always follow the medical advice and we'll always do our best to keep Australians safe.